The philosopher Eric Davis refers to humans as sparks that crackle with being and intuition, right? There is that sneaking suspicion that there is more to us than nature allows. You know, the human mind lives in the liminal zone that is not bound by time, by space, and by distance. There is a natural intuition to live in these spaces of dream, these spaces between, so to speak. We visit these zones when we're asleep every night, you know? The dream is real when you're in it, Chris Nolan says, in Inception. Noam Chomsky talks about psychic continuity, right? When we watch a piece of film, that is 24 still images per second, and then you introduce editing and cutting and cross-cutting across time, across space, yet psychic continuity links the events together and creates a contiguous experience. The human mind has no problem orienting its awareness towards dimensions in which time is no longer linear. We enter these virtual realities, or really they're real virtualities, and we believe them. We actively metabolize belief. We become immersed. The mind unplugs from the body and is not bound in any capacity. And that, eventually, I think, is where we're gonna go with all of our virtual reality technologies. We're gonna move towards universes of our own construction, as McKenna says. We're gonna move into spaces in which reality is going to be a relative term, where people might suffer from relativity sickness the way that they suffer from ADD today. It's a wild idea. I think that's where we're heading.